part one of a multi-part series going over Martin Lightjockey and its abilities on how to run lights. So let's go ahead and jump right into the program. Okay, so when you start up Martin Lightjockey for the first time, you're not going to have these two lights in here. These are just for video purposes. So let's go ahead and start drawing. Okay, so your first box is your sequence box right here. And this is where you're going to spend most of your time building your sequences, because sequences are the foundation of everything that you're going to be doing in here, as far as making lights do funny and crazy things or very cool things. And then you have your cue box right here to the right of it. Now this cue box, cues are a compilation of sequences that you can put in a certain order to work in a certain way. So once you get really advanced and really get the cues down, we'll go over to this next box, and it's called a cue list. And a cue list is basically a step up from cues, and now you have a cue list. So it's a list of cues that you can trigger at certain times, and that's used for if you have it on a set schedule of something, of a show. That's what you would use it for. You can put different time marks and everything, and different, you can tell this cue to go on at this time, or tell that cue to turn off at this time. That's used mainly on a timed song or moment in time. So that's more advanced as far as going into all that. So your next box is going to be the background cue and statics. So your background cue is your background cue. It's a cue that will run behind anything, regardless whether it's a sequence or a cue or cueless. It runs in the background no matter what, unless you turn it off. Even if it's a blackout, it still stays on. And statics are it's just a static sequence. This next tab is all your lighting abilities for a certain light. And take note, certain lights don't have certain features that are used in here. So, say for instance, this light only has these four tabs that you can use, because it doesn't have any effects, beams, or levels. So there's different abilities that different lights have. So your next tab is going to be your grouping tab, and this tab is a very important tab. Once you organize and assign all of your lights into your tab, by the way, I forgot to mention this entire white spot right here, all this is your tab. You put multiple lights where and design whatever way you want to. For personal preferences, I would like it designed the way I have it set up in real life. So these two lights would be right next to me, so I would put them on my left and right side. Personal preferences, I'll show you how to move them and assign them and unassign them. The light fixtures. Our next tab is pretty cool tab. I really like using this. So it's called a follow spot, and a follow spot is something you use is just in case something goes wrong that you weren't expecting. So say for this person was not standing in a spot that I had assigned the light to beam on. Well, you can use follow spot without altering the sequences or the cues. You can just move it and get to that certain position where that singer's at, or whatever that light's supposed to be at. That's use just for emergency purposes, as far as the light not being in a spot when it's supposed to be. I really like that feature, because I know sometimes when I've used this program, it's always had that problem where it wouldn't beam at that right moment or in that right spot. So our next tab, Amari Highline, is our master intensity and blackout tab. Also note that there's smoke control in here. And I won't be going into much detail with smoke in a hazer because I don't have one. But I've used one before. I'll show you how cool it is to use. So you have blackout and your master intensity. So your blackout is right here. It's basically what it says in the name is a blackout. This is your master intensity. Now, your intensity is how much light is you're allowing to be on. So, let's see. Let's go. So let's go into master intensity. Your master intensity. This is your master intensity. This, no matter what, regardless of what light it is, it's gonna turn off. As long as it's linked into one of these groups or just in the master tab. And there's different groups and everything. We'll go into all that in a later video, but for now, it's just that tab is really meant for fading out and fading in, and also blackout. But whenever you need to use this, it's very rare. It's if you really need to do something, and it was unexpected. So let's go over the sequence tab. So your very far left button is your sequence control, and this is organized through scenes. So what Mario and Lightjockey has is they have different scenes. So a very cool feature that is used in Lightjockey. So say for instance you want one light to be green. So let's go ahead and go to this light. I want this to be green with a 50% intensity. And I want this one to be, let's see, white and with 100% intensity. So that I would save that as a scene. And all you do is click this plus button right here, and it goes to the second scene. And then now I could change that to a, I guess, a green with a 50%. Okay, just reciprocate that, and let's go to 100%, and let's go to white. And it adds a very, very unique feeling to your sequences, because not only can you just add, you can change stuff, but you can make stuff move to different spots and everything. There's just tons of stuff. If you just sit there and play around with it, you'll do some crazy things. So scene time is how long the scene will run for, and then it will switch it to the next scene. Now you can always differentiate the scene times, but the fade time you always want to keep the same, because it looks kind of weird having 20 millisecond fade time, and then this one 0.05 fade time. I'll keep them both the same as far as fade times for each scene. That way it runs a lot more smoother than it not having it. And there's also different buttons. So this is another button. This one is a basically you can insert different scenes. So you can copy from another sequence and insert a scene. If you want to copy the sequence the scene that you have selected, then you just click that one and you can copy it. Other than that, I think that's all. So once you're done with it, you just click right here and just name it. So I'm gonna name it test. And there you go. So that's your first sequence right there. So this right here is, instead of going through there to do whatever you have to do, and you just want one scene for your sequence, just go ahead and switch where you want to switch. And then you hit this button right here, and you type the name of it, and then there you go. So sequence type is, it's basically giving it a description of what it is, other than giving it just a name. And then this is your folder. This is where you open up your folder for all of your different for all your different sequences. So you have test. Obviously, I have test and I have test twice. So those are your sequences. So now your cues. Your cues are very, very important as far as. In order to redo a lot of cool things with Lightjockey, you need to learn a lot more about cues in your sequences, because sequences can only do so much before you have to move on to your cues. So let me just go ahead and okay, so when you start off with the cues, you're not gonna have anything, so you just click the cue control, and this is your cue builder. You have all kinds of crazy buttons, but for right now I'm just gonna go right here and I'm just gonna drag. Actually, I might even have to drag, sorry. You just browse. Okay, so preferences, you have different modes. You have three different modes: drag mode, browser edit, and browser queue. what I was intentionally going to use was the drag mode. So we can just still use that. So let me hit the top one right here and drag it. And there you go. So now you have two sequences working. And you can disable them, turn them off or on, and then save it. So I'll just save it as test. Save as new queue, and then, and there you go, it's right there. Once you already have a queue set and it's already saved, hit new queue right here. And this also goes, this new button, new queue, this button right here goes for new sequence and new queue list. So this is your list of queues, your global list of queues. This is gonna have every single queue you've ever made in Lightjockey. But also you can delete them if you want to, and which I don't know if you want to. So if you have, these are different pages, so you have different pages as far as how many pages you want to use for your, to your liking. So I only have one page just for tutorial purposes, and so I'm just going to drag test from the global list of queues to this one. So you can have multiple queues in here, and you just double click it and it loads it. When I always use Lightjockey, just to be sure, I always make a queue called Blackout, and it's just basically you click off your lights and go to your fixture control and just hit intensity down. Oh, and as you can see, it's changing color and everything. And I would save that as a sequence and call it Blackout. Just to be on safe side, because usually if there's something that's done, the light turns on when it shouldn't be, then that's a problem. So I'm just going to go ahead and save that. Make sure to save it again. And then now I want to make a queue for it. Get that out of here. Blackout. And then just call it Blackout. And I just use it just to be on safe side. I wouldn't, if you don't really need to, I would use it. That's my personal preference. So yeah, that's your queue. This is a basic build of a queue. So let me go ahead and get that out of here. Okay, so test, if you can see, I'm gonna open up one of the light controls and you can see the system moving by itself. And that's just the basic part of it. It gets a lot more fun after that, after you learn how to actually use it. And all of his abilities. So let me turn off the first one and see what it does. See, okay, so now it's just doing that. So now if I add both of them, now it's going 50 and 37. Let me turn off 3 and let's see what goes. 50 through 200. And it's changing from green to white. Now, just like we had in the first, in that sequence that I made, the test sequence. Okay, so that's just a basic overview of a queue. That's how you use all the queues. Now, queue list I'll cover in another video. But for now, that's your queues and your sequences are very. It's very good just to practice and play around with it, because once you actually grasp the idea of how it works, it becomes very easy. And as far as making sequences and cues, I think that's it as far as for this video. Measure intensity and everything else. I'll cover more advanced topics. Leave a comment below if you have any more further questions. I'll be sure to get back with you. Check back in hopefully about a week from this upload. I'll have a new video discussing more in depth with cues and sequences, and then gradually we'll go and move on to the cue list and the background cues and all the other complicated and advanced features of Lightjockey. And I hope to see you next time on the next video. Thank you.